for the KZ2 final of the WSK Open Cup. Stan Pex will start from pole position in just a moment, and he, of course, won the Open Cup in 2020. How did he get there? Well, let's take a look at the highlights of a fantastic weekend here at Lonato. Giuseppe Palomba 1-0-1. He took pole position in qualifying on Friday afternoon on a dry circuit in a time of 45.512. He, of course, won the Open Cup in 2019 for the Birralar team, but he had a disaster in the pre-final this morning, and we'll start from dead last. The Dutch drivers have dominated this weekend, which has also seen the debut of Brando Badoer in his first ever KZ2 race. The young Italian qualified third, but will start way back on the grid for the final. Stan Pex for SP Tuning 113, the Card Republic, to line up on pole in just a moment for this 21-lap final. The skies, they're getting ever so slightly darker for the moment. It is a dry circuit, and we've got Vega Slicks mounted on the 33 shifter carts here this afternoon. Three drivers from the Netherlands, 1, 2, 3 on the grid. And the first non-Dutchman is Adrien Renaudin for CBB Sport, the Sodikart Sigma out of 4. And it's Gustafsson Dallet on the third row of the grid. We'll take a look at the grid for you in its entirety in just a moment. The cart's about to be pushed into life. Of course, we will be back in 2 weeks' time as well for the second round of the WSK Open Cup, a two-round series also in 2020, which Stan Pex did win from Danilo Albanese and Senna van Walstein. He finished third in the 2020 championship. Senna to start on the outside of the front row of the grid in just a moment. Incidentally, the 2022 WSK calendar has been announced. A fabulous series of 12 races, as ever, starting at Adria with the Champions Cup in January of 2022. You can check that out on wsk.it. We've still got this one. And of course, Adria in 2 weeks' time and the WSK Final Cup on November 21 before the end of a 2021 season, which has been somewhat calmer than 2020 when we jammed in 12 months of racing, as did the entire world, in just 7 short months. So we're just about to get underway with the KZ2 final. Drie piloten van de Nederlands in de eerste posities. Three drivers from the Netherlands on the first positions. Yes, I'm trying. Pex, Van Walstein and Laurens van Hoppen. 1, 2, 3 on this world-class grid here this afternoon. The wind is picking up ever so slightly. The track is dry. Just, we had a wet pre-final this morning. Stan Pex taking the 2020 championship, Giuseppe Palomba in 2019, and Riccardo Longhi won the 2018 WSK Open Cup from Marco Ardigo, and Moraine Kremers, who's incidentally here at the circuit. Moraine Kremers lapping at the nearby Franciacorta circuit with last week's Monza Formula One Grand Prix winner, Daniel Ricciardo. MK here at the track as ever with the Birralar team. As we look at the grid, it is Pex, Van Walstein, Van Hoppen, the three Dutch drivers, 1, 2, 3. Then Renaudin, Gustafsson, Dallet, Denner, and Vasile. Then we go to Danilo Albanese, Axel Bengtsson, Jenis Sivico, Norton Andreasen. He's alongside Xander Schurbilak, Thomas Arnberg, David Trevelov, the Russian for Team Maranello. Disregard the German flag, that's his license. Kaya Cixnellis, Alessandro Buran for Renda Motorsport, Joseph Knopp, Brando Badoe, his first ever KZ2 race. And then Jakob Bergmeister, Filippo Caligiaris, Jan Bednar, Matteo Simonini, Roberto Cesari, Joe Felbermeier, Muncien, Ebner, Ivan Klemenko, and another Romanian, Alex Iancu for Real Racing. Leonardo Marsiglia from the very back of the grid, along with Nicolò Rossini in the Brescia Racing Motors BRM, and Giuseppe Palomba, who won the title in 2019. Giuseppe Palomba third in the 2021 WSK Euro Series, which of course Birolat dominated 1-2-3 with Longhi, Kramers and Palomba. It will be one almighty drive, 1-0-1. Palomba, if you can win it from grid 33 here this afternoon. This is the Dutchman, SP Tuning Stan. The youngest of the three Pekstra brothers, Jan Jorrit. And of course, Stan, their father, team manager Richard, they go around for another formation lap. You can see the line is there. It's a clean line. It's not exactly rubbered in after the rain, which is now threatening over the paddock in the background. As now we look north towards the town of Desenzano on the southern shores of Lago di Garda. The beautiful lakeside resort town in the north of Italy, halfway between Venice and Milan. South of the Austrian Alps, in a direct line not too far at all from the Austrian border. And neither that of Switzerland as well. But it's the drivers from the Netherlands. 1-2-3 on the grid. Pecks, 1-1-3. Van Walstein, 1-1-5. And Lotens van Oppen. 1-0-5 for the Lennox Racing Charles Leclerc team. This is Stan. Will be near on unbeatable off the line if he gets the jump. But he's got 32 other drivers, most of which are equally as talented, right behind him. Stan Senna, the Dutchman on the front row of the grid. The WSK Open Cup, it is the reigning champion. From the 2020 WSK Open Cup, Stan Pecks to the right of your screen. Senna van Walstein in the soddy cut for CPB Sport. Trefiloff lines up. Cixinellis in the energy cut. Buran, not Baduera. Bergmeister, Kalijaris. There's Felbermeier, Muncien. We wait for Marcelia, who is in position four in the pre-final before a DNF. And to the right of your screen, out of grid 33, Palomba. We race. Perfect launch by the two Dutchmen. Senna van Walstein muscles his way by. It is a CPB Sport soddy cut 1-2 because Renaud Dunn has launched the soddy cut from the second row of the grid. Stan Pecks trying to go by as the clouds roll in just a few moments after the start of the KZ2 final. Fantastic start from Senna. He leads his French teammate down the hill. Renaud Dunn looks behind him, Stan Pecks. He will not be intimidated though, no problem. He'll fight back over the remaining 20 laps. So it is Senna van Walstein from Renaud Dunn. Stan Pecks in position three. Not the best start for Lotens van Hoppen, who's lost quite a few places. We look for Victor Gustafsson as well, the Swede who had a storming drive in the pre-final. Victor's come across the line in position six. Andrea Dalle. He's just ahead of Stan, now goes down the inside. Did not take long. The aggressive Dutchman looks over his right shoulder, drives down the right side of the track. Dalle, the pressure. He's one step off the podium in the CRG on his home circuit. As he races down the hill, Andrea Dalle, the former European champion, on the back of Renaud Dunn, who also has that same title. And there's Cixinellis going down the hill, headed for Bulldarmberg, Meister, Ebner, Knopf. Senna van Walstein will check the lead as they fight behind. He's pulling away. Senna, who finished third in the WSK Open Cup in 2020, has got a lead of 1.1 seconds. Back to Stan Pecks, who did start off pole position. Renaud Dunn back into P3, fighting from the Italian Andrea Dalle. 1-2-8 is the CRG. And behind him, we've got Denner, who's made a rocket start up behind Lotens van Oppen. Ahead of Daniel Vasile in the Modena Power DR cut, the Romanian in P7, ahead of Gustafsson and Danilo Albanese. Good start from Danilo Albanese. Remember, he finished second to Stan Pecks in 2020 in this race. Senna van Walstein with a nice lead as the race settles down in the early stages of the KZ2 final. He comes across the line. The gap stays at just about 1 second exactly, 1.038 to be precise. Back to Pex as Dallet still fights over the back of Adrien Renaudin. The CIG looks good here. It is manufactured not more than 3 kilometres from this circuit. As David Trefilov dives down the inside and takes the suspended Jenna Sivigal for the final position in the top 10, just in the background. The Maranello going by the DPK Racing Kart Republic of the Spaniard down through the chicane. That was the Daniel Orosic Racing Kart of the Romanian Daniel Vasile, who looks good here this afternoon. Victor Gustafsson with a purple sector last time round. For the moment, in the early stages, Dana, there he is in the Kart Republic. He's the quickest on the track. Sander van Walstein, Stan Pex, Adrien Renaudin, Andrea Dallet, Lorenz van Oppen, Emilien Denner, Vasile Gustafsson. There's Albanese in the background, second in 2020. The familiar driving style of the tallest driver in KZ2, Andrea Dallet, who's equally as quick as well, the 128 CRG down the hill, just a step off the podium on his home circuit at the moment. The gap between the two Dutchmen, 1 second. Sander van Walstein, Stan Pex, CBB Sport, the Zodikart Sigma from the Kart Republic. Another French-manufactured chassis, that of Renaudin in position three, the CRG. Then Lorenz van Oppen for Lennox Racing in the Charles Leclerc Kart. He's just ahead of Emilien Denner, who had a dominant victory at this circuit in the WSK Euro Series and the Supermaster Series for that matter as well. That was in another championship. That was in another team. That was when he was driving an Intrepid, just recently changing over to Kart Republic. And he's driving nicely here this afternoon. Emilien Denner, 1:09 in the Kart Republic, about to come into view. Well, maybe on the next shot. There is Vasile in the DR Kart. The best we've seen him drive for quite a few months now. We'll check his time. A 46.427. Just lacking one or two tenths off Sander van Walstein as Stan Pex now with a 45.815. The only driver to go under the 46-second bracket is Stan Pex. He's gone purple. Meanwhile, Norton Andreasen, and we spoke about the Super Swede in his first ever international KZ2 race, has just set a purple sector. He's behind his countrymen. The three Swedes, Gustafsson 9, Norton P11, Axel Bengtsson, just a place behind him, P12, three Swedes in the side, or in this field, in the 33 here this afternoon, which has now gone down to 25. I'll tell you why, because the DNFs are starting to mount up. Stan Pex with another fastest lap, a 45.811. Identical to previous. He's catching him. The gap is down to 6 tenths of a second. And before he does catch up and get on the back of his countryman, I'll tell you that Alessandro Buran has unfortunately retired, as did Jenna Sivigal, who was in position 10. Horst Felix Felbermeier, the Austrian, is out. Muhain Munsin is out. Cesari is out. Rossini is out. Alex Iancu is out. And Xander Sherbilak is also out as well. We're looking for Giuseppe Palomba from grid 33. Where's the Italian? You'll almost see in a moment. Position 15. A stunning start for Il Napolitano. Giuseppe Palomba in the 101 Kart. He's the fastest on the track now. You'll almost see him. The 101 Birola, there he is. What a drive from Giuseppe Palomba from the back of the grid of 45.776. From grid 33, he's up into position 15 behind the other similar Birola of Moritz Ebner. He's in 102, Palomba in 101. Unbelievable from Palomba, who launched from the back as we look at the leaders go by. CPB Sport 1-3, the Dutchman 1-2. Another fastest lap for Pex though, 45.732, but it's only versus 45.755 for Sander van Walstein. Renaudin, Dallet, Denner, Albanese, Vasile going through, then it's Trefilov, Van Hoppen, Norton Andreasen, Gustafsson, Imberg, Bengtsson. Kyasik Nellis in the energy car. The Lithuanian having a good race this afternoon. He's in position 16 because he's just been passed by Palomba a few moments ago. Palomba is storming through the field. The 2019 WSK Open Cup champion, Giuseppe Palomba, who was part of the Birralat trio, who finished 1-2-3 in the WSK Euro Series. The 2021 WSK Euro Series 4KZ2, won by Ricardo Longhi. Second was MK, and Palomba finished that championship in third. It gets a lot harder from here, though. He sits in behind Moritz Ebner, still cannot find a way by. So we concentrate on the lead for the front. This is half race distance. The KZ2 final here this afternoon at South Garda Karting Leonardo. The gap, half a second between the two Dutchmen. Senna van Walstein. The gap, 6 tenths of a second. Senna responds. So Stan Peggs, has he put all his cards on the table? He's put in fastest lap after fastest lap, but Senna van Walstein, he's put in the fastest third sector last time around. The gap, you can see, 0.6 at the bottom of your screen. There's Trefilov. Look at that in position 8 behind Vasile. Great drive from Davy Trefilov. 1-2-3, the Maranello of the Russian. Dale slides down into the chicane, the two card republics. Valbanese and Emilian Denner. Emilian in P5. Danilo in P6. Senna van Walstein wearing the colours of his namesake, wearing the colours of Brazil's most famous racing driver ever. The colours of the late great Ayrton on Senna's helmet. And the gap now 0.667 of a second. Just clips the ripple strip at the exit of turn three. There's Reynaldan in the background. The Soddy Karts 1-3. The legendary manufacturer from France, northwest of France, which of course won the 1993 Formula A World Championships with the great Davy Terrien Soddy Kart Futura, that famous kart of which very few exist, powered by the Rotax, the famous Perkins-sponsored blue machine of the Frenchman. Soddy Kart, different colours for them these days. By the way, if you ever do see one of those Soddy Cup Futuras for sale, let me know. They are as rare as hen's teeth. The current carts, the Soddy Kart Sigma, they're running 1 and 3 here this afternoon as the field race down through turns 1 and 2. There's Six Nellis ahead of Marcelia Baduea in his first ever KZ2 race, ahead of Bergmeister, Simonini, Bednar, Kalijadis. Not and showed the Chinese driver the final runner. Ivan Klimenko, the Ukrainian, also joins the list of retirements. Getting ever so slightly darker as we move into the closing stages of the KZ2 final this afternoon. Across the line last time, it was 0.639 of a second. We checked the time, 0.56. Stan is catching him. The Soddy Karts 1 and 3. The Dutch drivers 1 and 2. Senna van Walstein looking at a victory here this afternoon. Almost certainly it will be a Dutch victory, you would think. There's Norton going through behind Davy Trefilov. Norton, the first of the three Swedes. Victor in P11. Axel behind him, P12. With Laurens van Hoppen, who started third on the grid. The third Dutchman splitting the three Swedes. Laurens still in the final position inside the top 10. 6 laps now remaining. Senna van Walstein down through the gearbox. And now he accelerates. 0.63 of a second now, puts another tenth between himself and Stan. Soddy Kart versus Kart Republic. As now it gets darker here at South Garda Karting Leonardo, Senna tellingly looks over his right shoulder. Stan slams it down through the gearbox. Both TM powered for Senna van Walstein and Stan Peggs. Two very different chassis though. That will have given Stan Peck some encouragement to see Senna van Walstein look over his shoulder. He knows it is so much easier to chase than it is to lead, but the critical thing is he is in V1. We'll check the gap as they come across the line next time. Looks over his left shoulder, 0.4 of a second. and Stan is catching him. From 0.6 of a second, now he's got Senna van Walstein rattled. Super quick is Senna, but Stan is coming, says, okay, that's enough. I'm the top touchman. I'm coming for you. He takes 0.2 of a second out of him. Senna van Walstein, who has driven brilliantly for the first 16 laps, has now looked over his shoulder twice in the past two laps. Stan Peck's driving as hard as he possibly can in the 1-1-3 Kart Republic. On the back of the Sony car, closes in on the brakes as Senna van Walstein gets sideways under acceleration, puts near on 50 horsepower to the ground. Up through the straight, 0.3 of a second, he's right there. You can see the gap on your screen now. It is, what, 3-4 metres. He looks over his right shoulder. Stan Peck's almost close enough to make a move. Slightly defensive from Walstein. Stan Peck's will get the run on the exit. They race down the hill. It is the two-touchman. One of the strongest, one of the most famous countries in the world of kart racing. They've had so many great world champions over the past few years, the past few decades, I should say. And they're running 1-2 here this afternoon, three laps remaining. Looks over his right shoulder. The gap, it is irrelevant, 0.3 of a second. Senna van Walstein takes a big, deep breath and now tries to hold on for the remaining 3 kilometres. It is getting dark here at Lonato. Again, he looks over his right shoulder, middle of the circuit, to try and fend off, but that gives Stan the run as they race. Now up the hill, through the left-hander, accelerate down through the old turn 5 chicane over his right shoulder. Stan is coming. Senna starting to look a little bit nervous. Again, defensive. Stan with the traditional line will try and launch, but he's too far back this time. 2.4 kilometres to race. Two laps now remaining. Paul Bizalion, team manager, team owner for CPB Sport, watching on from the grandstand, from pit lane, nervous, seeing if Senna can take the victory here this afternoon. Now the traditional racing line, Senna too far back to capitalise, sorry, Stan too far back to capitalise on Senna. Up the hill for the penultimate time, the Soddy Kart versus the Kart Republic. SP Tuning, this is a nail-biting, thrilling final. Round one of two for the WSK Open Cup. Will Stan launch into the hairpin? Not this time. Here's another opportunity. Too far back. Just. They're about to get the last lap board. Dit is de laatste ronde voor de twee piloten van de Netherlands. So many of you watching on live from the Netherlands. Your boys run 1-2 here this afternoon. Senna van Walstein nervously holding on to the lead in the French Soddy Kart. Looks over his right shoulder. Stan will get the run on the exit and will try and make a move into the hairpin, possibly even the chicane. Down the hill, the Soddy Kart versus the Kart Republic. They grab another gear, puts it in the middle of the circuit. Stan lines him up, not here. Watch down into the hairpin, but he's ragged into the chicane. Two corners remaining. Stan misses the apex. Under acceleration, he's too far back. Senna van Walstein for Team CPB Sport wins a nail-biting KZ2 final. Stan Peck's across the line, a superb P2. And Adrien Renaudin makes it a Soddy Kart 1-3. What a race here at South Garda Karting Lonato. That was absolutely brilliant. Senna van Walstein has taken a fantastic victory. The Dutchman for the French team, for the French kart here in the north of Italy. In the end, the gap was exactly 0.30 of a second. As we take a look at the highlights, Stan from pole position, but this was arguably the move that won the race. Senna from the outside of the front row launched into the lead, pulled away. The gap was 1.5 seconds, so Stan did superbly well to bridge the gap to his countrymen. They pulled away from the rest of the pack. And at the end, Senna van Walstein took a fantastic nail-biting victory here at Lonato. It will be the national anthem of the Netherlands that we hear ring out at Lonato. The Dutchman finish 1-2 here this afternoon. Senne van Walstein, P1 with the victory for CPB Sports Sodikart. Stan Pex, P2 for SP Tuning, Kart Republic Motorsport. And Adrien Renaudin, the Frenchman, also for CPB Sports Sodikart on the podium in third. Albanese at F4, good drive from him. What about the Russian David Trefilov in P5 from Denner, Dalle, Van Hoppen, Norton in P9, and Victor, his countryman, the final position in the top 10. Giuseppe Palompa from the back of the grid. Fantastic drive from him. Il Napolitano finishes in P11 ahead of Vasile, Ebner, Imberg, Bengston, Kaya Sixnellas, Marcelia Badoea, Matteo Simonini, Jakob Bergmeister, Kalijardis, Josef Knopp, Jan Bednar, and Yao Zhao from China, the final finisher this afternoon. Stay with us on WSK.it, the podium presentation for KZ2 in just a moment. The podium for KZ2 as the Vega Caps go on the two Dutch drivers' heads, also the Frenchman here this afternoon. The Sodikarts finish 1-3 and the Dutchman 1-2 here this afternoon. We're about to get underway with a podium presentation for KZ2 here this afternoon. In third place for CPB Sports Sodikart from La France, Adrien Renaudin. Second place for SP Motorsport Kart Republic from the Netherlands, Stan Pex. The winner of round one of the WSK Open Cup here at South Garda Karting Lonato. Also for CPB Sports Sodikart from the Netherlands, Senne van Walstein. The national anthem of the Netherlands. The podium for the KZ2 final in third place, Adrien Renaudin, second, Stan Pex, and the winner of round one from the Netherlands for CPB Sport, it's Senne van Walstein. Three raced, one remaining here this afternoon, the OK Junior Final. The Emirati Rashid Aldehed is to start. From pole position. Stay with us, the OK Junior Final on WSK.it in just a moment.